So, Jeremy, looking ahead the next 3 to 5 years, you've had a wealth of different backgrounds. Give me some predictions about the media landscape. Where will it be?
Well, I think a couple of things we've learned is that obviously everyone recognizes that mobile is a huge opportunity. But I think what we're going to see is a lot more ability to capture the trends that are coming to the advertising industry. One is the huge proliferation of programmatic and long-tail advertising, essentially advertising that can't be bought by humans, but there's so much inventory out there. We're seeing tons of new small advertisers, my bread and butter, the local businesses, the small businesses, that are starting to try to make their offers more dynamic and hyper-localized. And then we're seeing a lot of course, the original source of the viewer's attention being on mobile. So we're going to see much more hyper-targeting of time-based offers and localized offers that will have a, therefore, higher value. And ideally, we'll see more money paid to publishers for that more limited inventory across the board, so everyone sees a rising tide. I have a kind of a hopeful vision where if we have accurate data, good demand from a very low level for specific inventory, and people who are effective at allowing the programmatic infrastructure for us to grab that demand on a very, very specific level, we can see better pricing for much more specific inventory that's useful to the advertiser, and bring all this inventory and create more value with it. It won't stop a lot of the fraud that we've seen out there, but it will make it much more specifically trackable and targetable. Because if I'm only advertising like Facebook's trying to do to people within a mile radius, well, I'm going to know if people walk in on that rainy day to take advantage of my free drink with your, purchase of lunch offer or something like that. So it's going to be a lot harder to pull the wool over the eyes of the guy behind the cashier. I think the other thing we're seeing right now is an incredible change in the payments infrastructure. And what's important for advertising here is, after all, that's the conversion. So we're seeing these point of sale systems like Square and Clover really tie together that last mile and prove the value. If I can tie my advertising to the cash register effectively, then that's essentially an unlimited amount of ad spend available as long as we can prove that conversion. And I think that's really the holy grail. Once we can tie the whole funnel to the ultimate outcome, then advertising becomes a natural investment, not something that you have to hope that people will understand on a qualitative level.
So what do you think the future is of the salesperson sitting at their desk at like a cable network? What do you think their job might be 5 years from now?
Interesting. I think the salesperson's job, there might be less need to sell the more commoditized stuff because it'll go more and more programmatic, but it's becoming creative and bundling up things like events and the commercials and the prime positions at a cable network or any publisher, the best stuff in a bundle that has more than the sum of its parts kind of value. So if they're doing, for example, I saw, some concert on the plaza, with the Today Show, if you can bundle that kind of sponsorship with the commercials that are appropriate and maybe the digital that surrounds it and offers that are related, unique content, time-sensitive content, content that people are passionate about, that's always going to have a premium. So to me, the sales force has to get more consultative, more creative, and it's not just a, a buzzword like native advertising. It's creating true brand experiences with unique content that people can then participate in and really, really not find anywhere else. That's what people will pay a premium for, I think, on the advertiser side.
How do you think connected TVs will impact the business?
Well, I think connected TVs allow us to take different levels of data and different levels of usage patterns and impact the commercials being shown. Now, when you're looking at television the traditional way, it's being shown against audiences. What we're able to do if it's over the top and things where maybe the same exact program is tapping into the smart television, we can actually use better data, things like frequency capping, even determining perhaps that there's a unique individual watching rather than simply a household determination based on usage patterns. So the more we can get people to use things like widgets, it's the same as a mobile device where the signed-in user on a television is going to provide us more data relevant to their history and allow for better targeting. And targeting always equals higher prices in the vast majority of cases. So it's actually a very good positive thing for both the advertiser and it should be for the user as well.